Hello. The goal of this video is to present you how to plan and monitor a project using the critical chain principles. To make this tutorial, we used Microsoft Project and an add-on called ProChain, which enables you to build critical chain schedules. In this example, we created a very simple project with only two sequences of tasks in parallel, which lead to a unique final milestone. The critical chain methodology requires a meticulous planning, and so you may have to specify more information than what you usually do. For example, we need our network to be dynamic. That's to say, we want a modification on a task to have consequences on others. So, we need to specify the links between the tasks and their durations, rather than just indicating start and finish dates for each task. Moreover, you have to indicate the degree of variability of the tasks. To do so, ProChain, for instance, asks you to indicate two different durations for each task. The first duration to estimate is called the focused duration. It is the duration that you only have 50% of chance to respect, so it is an ambitious duration that does not include a contingency time. It is the duration you need if everything works fine with good working conditions. These focused durations are the ones displayed in the Gantt chart. The second duration you have to estimate is the low risk duration. You have 90% of chance to respect such a duration. It is equal to the focus duration plus a margin. It will be shorter or longer according to the variability of the task. This duration is the one that people usually estimate for their tasks in traditional schedules, and this estimate is often two or more times the focus duration because people want to be sure to respect their commitment. Knowing these durations, ProChain can size the feeding buffers and the project buffer, which are used to mutualize the variabilities and protect the whole project rather than each task. Finally, it is crucial to specify which resources are in charge of the realization of the task, since critical chain is a finite capacity scheduling methodology. Once this work is done, we can turn our schedule into a critical chain schedule. The ProChain add-on does it on request. It puts forward the critical chain, which is the longest sequence of tasks in the project, and then it sizes and positions the feeding and project buffers. Remember, critical chain differs from critical path, since the task durations are focused durations with no such thing as a margin, and because it takes into account the resources which are leveled. And look, we can see in our example that the critical chain in red encompasses the task number 6, though this task number 6 is part of the second sequence of tasks. We have this chain because Julie can't work at the same time on task number 1 and task number 6, nor will she work at the same time on task number 6 and task number 3. As a consequence, we postpone the tasks and create a sequence of tasks which takes into account the capacity of Julie. And that's what we call leveling. Doing so, we do not plan multitasking. Finally, it is important to emphasize that the delivery date of the project is the end date of the project buffer, here the 22nd of February. Because of Murphy and contingency, we cannot ensure a delivery at the start date of the buffer, the 16th of February. Now that we have a critical chain schedule, we can execute the project and track its progress. In our example, we will consider that a week had passed and will update the schedule. And then we will consider that during this week, the task number 1 was finished, but the task number 6 could not begin. When you update a critical chain project, the remaining durations must be reassessed. So, since task number 1 is finished, its remaining duration decreases from 3 days to 0 day. However, as task number 6 is not started, its remaining duration is still of 5 days. And then, we update the project as if a week had passed. And in the appropriate view, it is possible to observe the delays of the various tasks compared to the initial schedule. Task number 6 has been delayed because it had to start within the week that passed, but it didn't, so it postponed the rest of the critical chain but also the feeding chains in blue. This sleeping task not only caused feeding buffers consumptions but also a project buffer consumption. However, because this project buffer is not totally consumed, the project is not late yet. Nevertheless, if we look at the fever chart, we realize that the point is in the red zone. What does it mean? Well, the horizontal axis represents the progress of the project and the vertical axis shows the buffer consumption. So, the point in the red zone means that we consumed the buffer too fast. And at this pace, all the buffer will be consumed before the end of the project. In other words, we'll be late. So, the manager must find solutions to accelerate project execution and shrink the buffer consumption so that the point goes back to the yellow zone or to the green zone. The fever chart, which is the emblematic tool of the critical chain methodology, represents a powerful warning system to detect early the delays which endanger on-time delivery, and as such, it highly facilitates the project management.